Maybe I'm crazy. I'd ever be the one you chose out of a thousand invitations.
Say that. I never have. Why are we in such a hurry? We have the rest of our lives. We have to kill him before he...
Before he what?
Andrew, before he finds out about us. We have to kill him tonight.
Ted, what if something goes wrong? You don't understand. I am terrified of Palmer. There are things I've been afraid to tell you. Something awful happened last summer.
What things? What happened last summer?
Well, Palmer and I own a house in East Hampton. Actually, I own it. Palmer just shows up. We gave a party one weekend last June. You know, everyone you leave town to avoid. Well, someone brought a man named Stephen Jessup. I was late getting out that weekend, so I never met him. But he was quite a knockout. By the time I got there, every woman in the room was salivating. But he was gone. He went for a walk in the dunes, and he never came back from that walk ever. I don't know what time the party broke up. There was a storm, and I fell asleep.
Well, where was Palmer?
Well, I didn't tell you. Palmer took a walk in the dunes, too.
Go on.
Well, I thought I heard a noise in the kitchen. I opened the door, and there was Palmer standing at the sink. He was washing his hands. He was covered in blood.
What?
Drenched in it. He said he'd been in an accident driving back from town, and he had a dog. And the amount of blood, it must have been a damn St. Bernard. Well, someone reported Jessup missing. The police came about 4 a.m. They found his clothes in the dunes behind the house. His wallet was still in his pants pocket and a very expensive watch. So there was no robbery. Palmer said that he didn't know Jessup, that he must have crashed the party or come with another guest.
Angie, he could have crashed. You know how those parties can get. What about the police? Did they find anything?
The police in the Hamptons don't know their way to the beach. Well, they traced him to New York, and they found his room. I got a report about that. But they never found him. Just another drowning.
Angie, you don't think he drowned. You think Palmer killed him.
So does someone else.
What are you talking about?
Well, about 4 days later, Palmer gets a letter in the mail. Newspaper print, cut out and pasted on butcher paper, just like in the movies. You killed Stephen Jessup and buried him in the dunes. Placed $25,000 in small bills. Put it in a litter basket, State Line Lookout, Palisades Park, next Thursday, 2 a.m., et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Well, Palmer went to pieces. I swear to you, Angie, it was an accident. He fell and hit his head on a piece of driftwood. I panicked. Oh, Angie, I buried him. Oh, you've got to help me, please, please. They'll send me to prison. I look terrible in stripes. And then he cried. Real tears. And I thought his Cyrano was bad.
So you paid?
Yes, I paid, and 2 weeks later he got another letter.
Another 25?
50. I told him it had to stop, that I wasn't gonna pay anymore.
Well, how did he take it?
He wasn't happy.
Well, Angie, look at it this way. Killing Palmer's gonna save you a hell of a lot of money.
You make it sound deductible.
Look, I'm glad you're with me. It makes what we're doing so much easier.
Then what? What if I forget something?
Look, you're not going to forget.
It's so confusing. The doors, the chloroform, and what about this Larry? You know, I hate bringing in a third person.
Look, would you stop worrying about Larry? He just happens to be a professional killer, that's all. Hell, in my neighborhood, every family had one. Angie doesn't have to kill anybody. All he has to do is pretend to be a robber and fake a robbery, that's all.
Why hire a killer to do that?
Because, look, I don't know of any professional robbery fakers. Angie, he's not your average goon. He's had 2 years of college before he entered the family business. I know him. We're good buddies.
Some good buddy. You have to pay him $10,000 to play parlor games?
Did you put the money in the safe?
Last night.
And you checked everything else out?
Yes, yes, yes. I still don't like it. What's this Larry's last name?
Prosciutto.
I will never order prosciutto and melon again as long as I live. You know, your good buddy Larry may not be so friendly when he finds out that you've set him up for Palmer's murder.
Angie, how many times do I have to tell you I'm not setting him up? The police are going to be looking for a junkie, not a hitman.
Don't underestimate the police. They just pretend to be stupid.
Pretend? Angie, this is New York. They're not pretending. 4 prominent citizens report that they were robbed by a junkie, that Palmer was killed by a junkie. Obviously, they're going to be looking for a junkie. The police are not going to suspect that this was any type of a hit. Now, come on, everything's going to be all right, I promise you. Starting tomorrow, it's just you and I. You put it all together, baby. You make it all happen. I can't lose that. I won't lose that ever.
Don't call me baby. morning, not a minute later. Lazy kind of day. Can't seem to stay out of bed. Just us and Ted Cotton. Yes, Palmer's agent. Yes, sweet boy. Okay, Gert, see you later. My sweet boy. Oh, boy.
You better start getting dressed.
Into the damn dress. You look adorable.
All for you, darling. Nervous?
Why should I be nervous? What's a little murder among friends? The gun.
The gun?
We forgot the gun.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I knew we'd forget something. You know, I didn't think it would be the gun.
Well, here, you do it.
You do it.
You do it. I showed you where.
I hate touching the damn thing.
Come on, the safety catches on. Don't worry.
Shouldn't I wrap it in something? My prints will be all over it.
Look, who cares? After a month, it's going to be in East River anyway.
Why do I have to tape it to the desk? Can't you carry it?
Angie, come on. The way these clothes are cut, I look like I had a tumor.
Now, look, we're halfway home.
Jesus Christ! Oh, my God!
Oh, God, I'm gonna faint!
No, you're not gonna faint!
My shot!
No, you're not checking!
I'm gonna faint!
Put your head between my legs! Oh, my God! Put your head between your legs! What the hell happened?
You pulled the trigger, that's what
I pulled the trigger! You pulled the trigger, and look, you blew a hole in the goddamn floor!
Thank God the people downstairs went home! I could have killed one of them!
The hell with the people downstairs, Angie! You could have killed me!
We are never gonna get through with this! The Three Stooges would be better at this than we are!
Look, you're okay. I'm okay. We're both okay. Now look, take it easy.
Take it easy.
Breathe deeply. Now go get dressed.
Get dressed.
Take the gun underneath the desk.
You do it.
You do it.
All right. I'll do it.
And remember, baby, starting tomorrow, it's just us.
Tomorrow? I don't think I can make it. And don't call me baby.
Give him anything?
No.
For God's sakes, Palmer, open the safe. Give him anything he wants.
No.
For God's sakes, Palmer, open the safe. Give him anything he wants.
No, wait.
Give him anything he wants?
No, we're not going through with it. Yes, I'm calling it off.
No. No, I... Wait a minute. Wait! All right. Yes, I understand. Yes, yes, I understand.
Well, what is it? What did he say?
There's no cancellation clause in his contract.
Call him back. Offer him more to call it off.
It's too late, Angie. He's already on his way. Look, we better go over everything.
Why didn't you tell him I'd be in red? You know I look terrible in red.
Look, I had to distinguish you and Gert somehow. I had to tell him that you'd be in red, definitely.
Why didn't you tell him I'd be in beige? You know, I look wonderful in beige. I am so damn afraid of the chloroform.
Angie, I wish you would just relax. Everything is going to be all right. Ready?
Ready. 11 o'clock.
Palmer arrives.
11:30.
Sagenberg's arrived.
You know, I hate involving Gert and Marshall in this.
Angie, we have to use them. If it was just you and I, it would look like some sort of a setup. 11:45.
You go in the kitchen. Why do you go in the kitchen?
You know why I go in the kitchen.
I know why you really go in the kitchen, but what is your reason for going in the kitchen?
Why?
Not very original.
Well, I like it. Now, where were we?
In the kitchen.
Right. I go in the kitchen, and I go downstairs. Jimmy the lock on the service door from the outside. Come up. Jimmy the lock on the kitchen door from the outside. Grab a bottle of wine, and here I am.
You timed it, didn't you?
Twice. 3.5 minutes, 4 at the most.
Okay, then just before midnight, Larry arrives. Your good buddy.
He robs us. But he wants more. He needs cash. He needs a fix right away. He wants to know if there's a safe in the apartment. And I say, for God's sake, Palmer, open the safe. Give him anything he wants.
You've been rehearsing.
Yes, I have. Then he forces me to tie up Gert and Marshall, and then you. And then he chloroforms them. And he pretends to chloroform you. I repeat, he does not chloroform the lady in red.
Then he forces you and Palmer upstairs.
Right. Once we're upstairs, Palmer opens the safe. Larry's job's over with. He splits. He grabs what he finds in the safe and beats the hell out of town. Then I grab the gun from underneath the desk and bam! You're a merry widow. You know, I wonder what Palmer's gonna think when he sees his agent holding a gun on him.
That you want your commission.
After I kill him, I come downstairs. And then I tie myself up. And I pretend to be chloroformed. And then we wait. We lie there and wait until Gert and Marshall come too. Once they revive us, I call the cops. And there you have it. Four distinguished New Yorkers who have been brutally mugged and witnessed a fading Broadway star go to the big stage in the sky. Another victim of Fun City. Well then, that's that.
Yes. That is that. Come to Mama.
Ooh. How about we open that bottle of wine and have a glass before the floor show begins?
I wonder where we'll be in 6 months from now. In bed, I trust. They should put that on coins.
What should we drink to?
Old age. I can hardly wait.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Hello, Angel.
My God. Jesus. In here, darling.
What's on the cradle? What is he doing here?
Behold, he has arrived.
Hello, dear. I am so happy you're home.
You're late, or early.
We came down early. No laughs. But I got even. I didn't smile at the curtain call.
Hello, Ted.
Hello, Palmer.
Cheer up. You look like the audience I just left. What's new?
Have we got a surprise for you?
They found Amelia Earhart.
Chateau de Saint-Blanc. Marshall sent over a case.
Hell, Gert will be through that before midnight. Turn around, darling. Let me look at you.
Do you approve?
Absolutely. Not bad for an old broad.
You never fail me.
Ted, are you nailed to this spot? How about taking care of your most prestigious client and making me a martini? Very dry.
Darling, it's New Year's Eve. Have a glass of wine. Ted was just dropping
opening the bottle.
Opening the bottle. That's what I meant.
Tradition. What a load of crap. Ted, be a good agent. Martini.
We better let him have what he wants.
Isn't it a little bright in there? You could televise a hockey match.
mutes. What time are Gert and Marsh arriving?
Too soon, I'm afraid. I better finish getting myself together. Whoever invented makeup should be boiled in it.
Max Factor, I think. I think that's how the poor devil met his end. Anything to Nosh, darling? I'm starved.
In a minute.
Here you are, sire.
A masterpiece. Well, here we are, Ted, another year older. How do you feel?
Another year older.
Everything set?
Everything's set.
Just before midnight?
Just before midnight.
Well then, come to Papa.
Ooh.
Taking another bow.
I'm sorry. I had a case of the last minute nerves. I'm all right now.
Are you sure? No second thoughts?
No second thoughts.
Good. Because you were quite agreeable when we started the nasty deed. And to its reward.
I still am.
Does that mean to me or to my wife's fortune?
Both.
Sweet, greedy Teddy. You seem tense.
It isn't as easy as I thought it would be.
That's life, Ted.
I mean, for weeks we've been planning. She's been invisible. She's been Mrs. Palmer Forrester.
And now?
She's, a friend.
Why, Teddy, don't tell me you have a crush on my wife.
Oh, Palmer, you know me better than that.
Yes, I do. And I can understand your feelings. It's a lot easier to kill a stranger than a friend. But that's showbiz, Ted. Tell me, how is it with us?
You know how it is.
Tell me again.
Everything's gonna be all right, I promise you. You put it all together, baby. You make it all happen. I can't lose that. I won't lose that, ever.
Understated, but effective. And don't call me baby.
I'm sorry.
Sweet, greedy, simple Teddy. You mustn't be sentimental about Angela. She's not all the woman you think she is.
Homer, what are you talking about?
If only you knew.
If only I knew what?
How your dreams would be shattered.
Homer, what the hell are you talking about?
Oh, I guess I can tell you. You're old enough to stay up with the adults now.
Tell me what?
Something terrible happened last summer at the beach.
Last summer?
I promised myself I'd never tell anyone. But you deserve to know.
Then tell me.
Angela and I own this little place in East Hampton. Nothing much, 17 rooms. Last summer, I met this young man, quite adorable. His name was Stephen Jessup. You should understand that. Boys will be boys. Before I knew it, we were playing Lawrence of Arabia in the dunes. Oh, the end of June, Angie and I threw a little party. Stephen came, had a couple drinks, and then he left. I was supposed to meet him later at the beach, but when I got there, no one was there. I looked around. I became scared. I felt like someone was watching me. And then I found him, still warm and sticky with blood. Someone had cut his heart out.
Oh, Jesus Christ!
I panicked. I was covered with blood. I figured the police would blame me, so I buried
him in the dunes.
Yes.
Did anyone see
Gino?
Oh. No, she couldn't.
Oh, when I got back to the kitchen, Angela was washing the blood off of her hands and the knife. She looked as if she'd been in a train wreck.
But why?
Because in her own perverse way, she still loves me. I think she'd rather see me dead than to lose me. Oh. She found out about Jessup and me, and look what happened to him.
What about the police?
They assumed he drowned. The usual questions, but nothing. Oh, sweet boy, tragic.
I just can't believe this. I can't believe it.
You'd better believe it. Someone else does.
Ever since Stephen disappeared, she's been paying blackmail to someone. I found the letters in her shoebox in her dressing room. Newsprint, cut out on butcher paper. Obviously an amateur.
Well, why didn't you tell me this before?
Would it have mattered?
No.
Why, Teddy, I think I see fear in your eyes. Oh, lightning in the wintertime. That's good luck. Ted, when you called me, you were cautious? She couldn't have overheard?
No. She was upstairs getting dressed. Why the hell don't you just divorce her?
What, and be left penniless? It's a little bit late to be moving into the YMCA. So, we go as planned?
Yes, we go as planned. Look, they're gonna be here any minute. You know, we better go over everything.
Why? I know my life.
Just to be sure.
I feel like I'm back in stock. Okay, run it.
11 o'clock.
I arrive. So far, we're in.
11:30.
Gert and Marshall arrive. A little pleasant chit-chat. Champagne, caviar.
11:45.
What?
The kitchen.
Oh, yes, the kitchen. You go into the kitchen for more napkins.
Wine.
Wine?
Wine. Wine sounds so much better than napkins. Napkins sound so dull.
All right, if you say so. And then I keep everyone highly amused while you play locksmith. How long should that take?
3.5 minutes. 4 at the most.
Then just before midnight, Larry arrives.
Your friend, Mr. Prosciutto.
Yes.
You know, I sure hope he can handle this.
For $10,000, he can handle anything.
$10,000 is a hell of a lot of money just to fake a robbery.
Inflation. It's every cent I could beg, borrow, and steal. And it all has to be paid back after my poor wife is laid to rest. Sure hope she likes mahogany.
Larry takes what we have in our wallets, our watches, our rings, etc. But he wants more. He needs cash. He needs a fix right away. He asks if there's a safe in the apartment.
Get ready, Teddy. Here comes your big moment.
For God's sakes, Palmer, open the safe. Give him anything you want.
Bravo, bravissimo. Olivier would have thrown himself into the Thames.
Then he forces me to tie up Bert, Angela, and Marshall. And then I help him chloroform them at gunpoint.
Of course. And then we take Larry upstairs. I open the safe. He gets his money. He takes off. He's out of it. Then we come back down. And I give another dose of chloroform to Angela. An overdose, so to speak. And the police start looking for the junkie, who in the process of robbing us has killed poor Mrs. Forrester. Perfect, isn't it?
The chloroform sounds so brutal.
You could always bore her to death.
Thanks. Did you check the safe?
Of course.
You know what to report, Miss
Safe. Of course.
And what about Larry's money?
Right here.
Palmer. What would you do if I decide to call it off?
Nothing much. Just call the agency and tell them you're a sissy. Yeah.
Do you still make it with her?
Only when I don't have a headache.
I'm serious, do you?
Why, Teddy, you're jealous.
If you only knew how much.
Ah, here she is. Darling, you take my breath away.
That's the idea.
I wish there were two of you. Then we could have such lovely bookends.
Sorry I took so long. I broke a heel. What have you two been talking about?
How you spent your summer vacation.
Angie, do you need any help in the kitchen?
Thank you, Ted. It's all ready. Just bring it in.
Why don't you show me?
Palmer, you forgot to hang up your coat.
Oh, so I did. How shocking.
And take Ted's, will you?
I've got to talk to you.
What's wrong?
That story you told me about Stephen Jessup.
Not now.
Will you tell me the truth? I've got to know.
You've got to know what?
That's what I call timing. Darling, will you open the wine and I'll get the door? Bert, darling! It's Marshall here.
Here we are. Right on time. Happy New Year.
To all of us.
And you, glorious. Where is Rasputin?
Behind the bar. Where else?
Hello, dirty Gertie. How's your ass?
Beginning to go, like the rest of me. How's yours?
Firm as a teenager's. Wanna feel?
No thanks.
Where'd you get the cake? Bela Lugosi? Marshall, how's my favorite producer?
Dying.
Here, let me pour you some New Year's cheer.
Gert, what a marvelous cake!
Isn't it?
That dress! My God, that dress!
Isn't it divine? It makes me Spanish.
But I thought you were going to wear that hideous green thing you bought in St. Thomas.
Hideous? You said you loved it.
Well, you look stunning in that color, Bert.
I must say, I've never had such a reaction to a dress before.
Here, love.
Thank you, sweetheart. Maybe I should have worn black.
Actually, it would have been more appropriate.
Why? Is there someone in mourning?
Almost.
Angie, I know. You wanted to be the only one in red.
As a matter of fact, I did.
Now we have two lovely ladies in red.
So how was the house tonight?
Small, but hostile.
Now, we're not going to sit here all night and talk shop. Marsh, you promised no grosses.
All right, all right. Say, you know, you two do look like the Supremes.
Oh,
Happy New Year.
That's clever.
Oh, Ted. Say, you know, everywhere I go, there always seems to be an agent. Why is that?
But he doesn't look like an agent. He's over 5'6". Hello, Ted.
They're always so small. I think about it often.
Gert! That dress! My God, that dress!
I thought you'd like it.
I'm gonna have to wear this more often.
Gert, what color would you call that exactly?
Red.
That's what I thought.
Actually, it's called Scarlet Tangerine. Angie, you've really saved our lives this year. What a lovely idea to just sit here and get dead drunk.
Hey, you know all that midnight hoopla? This is definitely much more dignified.
Yes, we weren't invited anywhere either.
Gert, you look cold. Why don't you put on your coat?
Cape!
Cape?
She wore a cape.
Why don't you put on your cape?
Did you two take something before I got here?
Oh, it's a little chilly in here. I could get you a shawl.
No, thank you. I'm not cold. I don't need a shawl, and I don't need a cane and a tin cup either. Is something funny going on?
Don't ask. No!
Well, how is it with the Sadie Birds? Any New Year's resolutions?
I haven't.
I've made one. The next time I produce a show, I'm staying out of New York. No offense.
How are things at the theater?
A woman passed out in the box office yesterday.
Why? Did someone buy a ticket?
Bert, this play is going to run.
Not unless you put it on wheels and push it downhill.
You know, those notices.
Those notices weren't that bad.
As funny as a cry for help is not considered a good notice.
Especially for a comedy.
Well, at least the critics were kind to me.
Yes, he was.
Does anybody know what time it is? I don't want to miss the ball dropping.
What ball?
Times Square. He watches it every year. He likes the countdown.
I do not.
I powder my nose.
Gert, if you put any more powder on that nose, you will look like Louis the 14th.
I'm not going to powder my nose. I'm going to powder my nose! Good for you, Gert.
Gert, let's have a toast first, and then you can powder your goddamn nose.
Fine, I'll powder it later.
Teddy, seeing as you're so good with words, why don't you do the honors?
Yes. We do have a lot to drink to this evening. To the truth.
If there's one thing I don't need, it's the truth.
I'm with you. Cheers.
Chin chin.
Hi.
Up, everybody's.
Gertie, you're always up on the latest things. What's the latest rumor?
Well, I don't know a damn thing. Unless you're talking about that terrible story that I heard.
Gert, that's a mean story, and it's not true. I don't know why you insist on telling everybody.
I never said it was true. I simply said it was terrible.
I am going to love it.
Well, apparently, one of our most cherished celebrities is stepping out on his wife.
Is that it?
With another man.
Oh, my God!
Ted, and when you come back, will you bring back more wine?
Yes, more wine. Yes. We could all use more wine.
Yes, I'll bring back some more wine.
I shouldn't be going three half minutes for the
book. Where are you going?
Into the kitchen to sponge off my dress.
No. You can go upstairs.
She can't go upstairs.
Why not?
Because it's almost midnight. She has to be in the room at midnight.
Why?
Because it's New Year's, damn it! Sponge yourself up at the bar. Angie, help her.
Gert, I want you to promise me one thing. Never wear that dress to an opening. Say, how much did that dress cost me anyway?
About 1.5% of the gross.
Oh, God, there goes $12 down the drain.
Oh, hell, Angie, this is gonna stain. Don't you have any spot remover?
No!
Of course I have spot remover. It's upstairs. Go and get it.
Use club soda.
We're out of club soda.
Gert, you are a pain in the ass.
Not as big a one as you.
Hurry up, Gert. Go and get it.
And hurry back down, goddammit.
Take your time, Gert. We have plenty of time.
All right. I'll hurry up and take my time.
I am having so much fun. Isn't it almost midnight?
Midnight? I don't want to miss the countdown. Ted, you're out of breath.
I'm excited about the new year.
How's everything in the kitchen?
I was just going to ask the same thing.
Where's the wine?
Wine? What wine?
You went into the kitchen to get more wine.
Oh, I did.
Oh, never mind. There's plenty of wine. Look at all this wine. Ted, would you? Anybody want some?
Piggy-doo.
Ted?
Wait. Ladies first. Gert must be dying of thirst by now.
She's probably in a spot remover by now.
Here, take this up to Gert and bring Gert back down.
For God's sakes, Palmer, leave Gert alone.
All right, everybody.
Oh, yeah.
Now, you do exactly as I say, all right? Right, you see this? This is no toy now, this is the real thing.
All right, now you listen to me very, very carefully. Now your wallets, your jewelry, everything you got, right there on the table.
Is this some kind of joke?
Hey, this is no joke, mister.
You really don't think you're gonna get away with this, do you?
Shut up, your face. Come on, move.
There, get up.
Hey, what?
That's right, lady. Do you want him to live a good long time?
Please, don't hurt him.
Then get your ass down here. Move it.
Hey, Junior, close those doors. It's cold in here, huh?
Wait.
Wait a minute.
Okay.
Hey, close those doors. Come on.
Hey, is this your purse?
Yes.
Here. Hey, come on.
Empty the stuff. Put it in the bag.
Come on, move it. I ain't got a hook.
Hey, you two. Sit here on the couch. Come on. And you in that chair. Come on. I ain't got all day now. Come on. Give me that stuff in there. Shit.
No. Hey, this shit ain't gonna keep me going for 2 days, huh? What's wrong with you people? Come on. Hey, ain't you got a safe in this place? Hey, Junior, you got a safe in this place?
Hey, lady, that's really smart. Smart. It's uncanny.
I should know if we have a safe. I'm his wife.
Yeah, that's right, yes. After all you rich people got safes, huh? Hey, is this your place?
See, yes. It's upstairs.
Great, because you're going to open it.
Hey, Junior, come on, wake up. Here. Come on, tie him up.
Do as he says, Ted.
That's right. Come on. Those two, back to back. Her right here in this chair.
Marshall.
Do what he says. Maybe he won't hurt us.
That's right. Now you got the idea, huh? Ow! Hey, watch it. You don't want this thing to go off now, do you?
Hey, I'm not in no too good shape, you know. I need a fixing real bad, huh?
Oh, cheers.
You got them tied up?
Yes.
Oh, come on, move it.
I got all day.
Hey, is this your place?
You're seamless, Crooked.
hey, come on, man. You know, you got a nice place here, man, but what's wrong with you?
You could use a little color here, yes. You don't like color? Come on, man. You could put a little green in here, a little blue, a little red, a little purple.
Now we're being mugged by an interior decorator.
Now, we're all going to take a little nap. That way, everybody's going to stay on the phone a good long time, huh? You see this? Do you know what this is? Huh? This is chloroform. Yes, chloroform. Hey, do you know what this is?
No, you can't. Marshall!
Shut up, you face. Hey, you got them tied up?
Yes.
Great. I'm going to need your help.
I can't.
Hey, look, you do like I say. Or maybe you would like to watch while I blow this nice lady's head clean off.
You wouldn't dare.
Oh, no? Oh, no? Hey, man, you know, I'm a mean dude, man. You know, one time I killed a puppy dog, and then I ate him.
Hey, you got him tied up yet?
Yes.
Well, come on over here and pour. Come on.
I'm afraid I'm going to pour too much. I may kill somebody.
Well, then you go to jail. Hey, look, guy, it ain't a bad place. I've been there myself. Yes.
And you'll be pretty popular there.
Pretty boy. Now, pour.
That's it. Open it up. Put it on the thing. Come on. That's enough. That's enough. Now keep it. Come on. Give it to me. That's enough. Now put the lid on it. All right. Now put it down nice and easy like. All right. That's it. That's it. Good. Now go stand with the head honcho, huh?
Come on. Move it. Move it. Move it.
Jeez. 99.
I swear I'll kill you.
Hey.
I will.
Hey, mister. You know, you got a big mouth.
Gert.
But we gonna fix that, right?
Gert. Gert.
And now it's your turn.
No.
Yes.
No, please.
Yes.
No.
And now he's done. Yes. Pretty good, huh?
Inspiring. Like me playing Shaw.
Yes, yes. Now upstairs. Open the safe.
Huh?
Thank you.
so upset. The way those damn policemen kept badgering her with question after question. They made her feel like she was the one under suspicion.
It sure didn't help if Palmer started yelling at her, blaming her for all that damn confusion.
Sorry it took so long. I had to get out of that damn monkey suit. Here, let me freshen your drinks.
Jesus, what a way to start a new year.
Poor Teddy. He was like a son to me. I don't know what I'm going to do now. I think I'll go to the William Morris Agency. I shan't be playing the matinee tomorrow. I am shattered.
But it's New Year's Day. We've got a half a house.
I don't care if it's Yom Kippur and they're hanging from the rafters. I'm not playing.
Oh, Angie, there you are. I hope you're feeling better. You know, I was thinking you and Palmer ought to stay with us tonight. Every reporter in town will be on your doorstep in the morning. My God, can you see the post tomorrow? Thank you, dear. That's very sweet of you. Palmer, you and Angie are staying with us tonight.
Nonsense.
We wouldn't dream of letting you stay here, would we?
It is very sweet of you to be concerned about the two of us, but we're both quite all right.
You do the same for us. My God, I hope you never have to.
Gert, you must be exhausted. You've been crying for the last 3 hours. Why don't you do us all a favor and just go home?
Palmer's right, Gert. You need your rest. We'll be fine, really.
I do still have a headache from that damn chloroform.
Come on, Gert, let's go home.
I have to powder my nose.
Is that all she ever does?
You know, the first thing I'm going to do when we get home is burn this dress.
Gert, make sure you're not in it.
My God, what's that?
The police chalk, remember?
They left it as a souvenir.
I'm too pooped to powder my nose. I think I'll do it the next time I'm here.
You know, it must have been terrible for you to see Ted killed that way.
Yeah, and to have to step over him on the way down to revive us. Oh, blood.
I didn't have to revive Angela.
You didn't?
No. When I came out of the bedroom, she was fully conscious and standing at the bottom of the stairs. Weren't you, darling?
But you were in the chair. How did you untie yourself?
It took a lot of practice.
Gert, Angela is a very clever girl. More than clever, she's inspiring.
Like you, playing Shaw? I've always been good at untying knots. I was a brownie.
You were? I didn't know that. What the hell is a brownie?
It's like I told the police. I don't know how I untied myself. I was in shock. I only blacked out for a few moments. He obviously used less chloroform on me than he did on you. When I came to, I just untied myself. I was about to phone for help when I heard the gun go off. When I heard that shot, I thought for sure you were dead.
Well, there's one thing to be grateful for. It wasn't one of you. You still have each other.
Yes.
I'll drink to that.
You'll drink to anything.
Can I ask a question? Why was everyone so edgy tonight? Before the robbery, I mean.
Yeah, what was all that about getting Gert up and down the stairs before midnight?
An old Islamic superstition. On New Year's, everyone has to be in the room at midnight, or someone dies.
I'm going to have to pay attention to that one. I didn't even know they had New Year's Eve in Islam. Where is Islam anyway?
Marshal, will you please take Gert home? I'm exhausted.
Come on, Gert, let's go home.
I'm not going anywhere until I know Angie's all right.
Gert, Angela is in perfect health. She could dance the night away. I, however, am extremely ill.
I'll be fine, Gert, really.
All right. Good night, you two, and get some sleep.
Good night, Gert. Sorry to see you run off like this.
Remember, things will look much better in the morning.
Even Gert.
Well, Gert will be...
Gert will be getting some sleep. Did you hear that? Gert will be getting some sleep.
We should do this again next year. We could form a tradition. Well, Isn't this a tense little moment?
I'm not tense. Why should I be tense? Are you tense?
This room is vibrant with tension.
That's not tension, Palmer. That's rigor mortis. After tonight, we're dead, both of us.
You, my dear, have been dead for quite some time. I've been meaning to talk to you, but the holidays have been so hectic. I, personally, though, am vibrantly alive and intend to stay that way.
Ted was alive, too, but he's not anymore.
Are you telling me to watch my step?
I'm telling you he was alive, but he's not anymore.
Is this my Angela, this Medea?
I'm going upstairs, Palmer.
You're not going to sleep in that room.
No, I guess I can't.
Why don't you stay in my room? I'll be perfectly comfortable here on the couch.
That's very kind of you.
Angela, by the way.
Yes?
What was all this about Gert's dress?
What dress?
The one she was wearing.
Oh, the red dress?
Not red. Scarlet tangerine. When you saw it, you almost had cardiac arrest. So did Ted.
I was surprised, that's all. She told me she was going to wear green. You know I like to be the only one in whatever color I wear.
And why was Ted so surprised?
Was he?
Either that or he was having a seizure.
Good night, Palmer.
Angie?
What is it?
Talk to me. I'm lonesome.
I've just spent 3 hours with New York's finest. I don't feel like talking anymore.
Please?
What do you want to talk about?
The American dream. Why did you tell that junkie we had a safe?
Because he asked.
That's a straight answer.
I'd like to ask you a question. Why would a careful man like Ted take a gun away from a raving junkie?
You know how aggressive agents are.
That is what you said happened.
Yes, that is what I said happened.
I'm exhausted, Palmer. Good night.
Angela, darling.
What is it?
One more question before you retire.
Yes?
Come down here, darling. We can't talk like this. Now, what the hell is going on?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You know goddamn well what I'm talking about. I'm in red. She's in scarlet tangerine. Open the safe for him, Palmer. Give him anything he wants. That was a signal for someone, was it?
No, it wasn't a signal to anyone.
Yes, it was a signal to Ted or to someone else.
No.
You were not chloroformed, and you know it.
He did chloroform me.
Inspiring, like me playing Shaw, I said that after you were chloroformed. Hello, Palmer Forrester. Lieutenant Brennan, and how may I be of further service to you? I see.
Yes.
Yes, of course. I'll be right down. You don't need my poor wife, do you? The darling is tired out. How very kind of you. No, not at all. We must do everything we can to catch the monster. Goodbye.
The police?
Yes, they want me to come back down to the station.
Now?
They have a suspect. They want me to come identify him.
How can you identify him? He was wearing a mask.
There are many ways to identify a man, by his height, his voice.
I'm going to call Gert Marshall.
You are not going to call Gert Marshall. You are not going to call anyone. You are going to do exactly what I say, or I shall tell the police that when I opened the safe, I found $10,000 in it. $10,000 that wasn't in it yesterday when I looked. That sounds like a payoff to me. What does it sound like to you?
That was my house money.
I'd like to see you tell that to Lieutenant Brennan.
Be careful, Palmer. Be very careful.
A warning from Rebecca of Sunnybrook Farm?
If you tell Brennan about the money, I'll tell him you killed Stephen Jessup and buried him in the dunes.
You do that little thing, darling.
It's so funny, Palmer, I could use a laugh.
You tell him, and then tell him where to find the body.
I'll find it. I can dig up every dune in the Hamptons, east, south, west, and bridge.
I dug him up and moved it.
Where?
Oh, to a vault in a Chase Manhattan. Angela, you are a bore. I'm leaving. When I come back, I will expect you to be here and wide awake. We can then continue this conversation about the curious events of the evening. And while I'm gone, you may think up some witty repartee. By the way, don't even think of running. Don't even think of it.
Don't even think of running. Don't even think of it.
There is no Larry Prosciutto. I'm Stephen Jessup.
Palmer killed Stephen Jessup and buried him in the dunes. I paid thousands of dollars to...
To Palmer.
Palmer?
To Palmer.
I don't understand.
Look, listen to me and you will. Now look, one weekend last summer, I was bumming around in the Hamptons, see, working out in the dunes, knee bends, push-ups, keeping in shape, you know. Well, I was being watched. I could feel it. I looked around and there he was, the one and only Palmer Forrester in person. His beach umbrella, his cashmere blanket, his pitcher full of martinis.
Palmer likes to rough it.
Halfway through those martinis, we realized that we had a mutual need. Money. You see, Palmer was in debt with the Sharks. Me, I was just broke. Well, Palmer figured out a way that he can get his hands on some of yours. Buddy needed my help. So I show up at your party. I'm wearing my white bathing trunks. I'm all tan. I look great. Hey, I get a lot of attention that night. And then I disappear.
And how do you do that?
I take a walk in the dunes. Please. It's all right. Now, an hour later, Palmer shows up with some of his clothes. I ditch mine in the dunes, see? My wallet, my IDs, my key, everything. I don't go back to your party, and I don't go back to my pad in New York. Palmer, he splatters himself with a little fake blood. He does a number on you, and then he phones the police and tells them that one of his guests are missing. Well, they ask a few questions to no answers. The next day, they go to my place in Queens, but they find it empty. You see, Mrs. Forrester, when I walked off that beach that night, that was the end of Stephen Jessup. 4 days after that, Palmer wrote himself his first letter.
He wrote them himself? There was no murder, no blackmail?
No murder, no blackmail. The next day, I went to New York, and I rented a room in Queens. But not as Larry Prosciutto. Not as Stephen Jessup. As Larry Prosciutto. You see, Stephen Jessup was already dead. So, Palmer picked out the name Larry Prosciutto. He said it cracked him up. To him, it sounded like a hitman. So, you see, he paid me to stay put in Queens with the money that you paid him.
Wait till I get my hands on him.
Look, Mrs. Forrester, I got shafted here tonight. I need some answers.
You've got the wrong girl.
Look, I got him out of here tonight so I can talk to you. You gotta know something. Look, the red dress.
I don't know anything. You got him out of here.
That was me on the phone. You see, he was making it sound like he was talking to the police when really I was telling him that I was gonna meet him in one of those porno places up on 42nd Street.
Why?
When Palmer hired me to fake this robbery, he didn't say that somebody was gonna get hurt.
When Palmer hired you?
Yeah.
But Ted hired you.
Ted? Who's Ted?
Ted Cotton, the man you shot in my bedroom.
You mean the man that Palmer shot in your bedroom?
Well, I've gone round the bend. Palmer hired you to fake a robbery, and Palmer shot Ted.
Right.
And I don't know it's not second.
What?
How much was Palmer going to pay you?
$10,000. But look, I never laid eyes on this Cotton guy until I came in here tonight.
But Ted and I have been planning this thing for weeks. Everything, every detail, everything exactly the way you did it. The locks, the chloroform, the safe. The robbery was just a cover. We were going to kill Palmer. Oh, my God. You're not a cop, are you?
Hell no. I'm an actor.
This has been a very bad day for me.
So you were going to burn Palmer? Man, that's heavy.
I count on your discretion.
How are you going to do it?
Well, after you cleared the apartment, Ted was going to shoot him.
And say that I did it?
Not you, the junkie.
Well, is that what Palmer told the police?
Yes.
Well, either way, I'm wanted for murder.
Not you, the junkie.
Mrs. Forrester, if they catch the junkie, I go to jail. God, you know it was a black bitchin' day today I met your husband. First he tries to put a hole in me, and now he's blaming me for knocking off this cotton guy.
Palmer tried to kill you?
When he opened up that safe, instead of pulling out the 10 grand that he owes me, he pulls out a 45 and puts a big one in your guy Cotton, and then he turned the gun on me. And that is where he made his mistake, lady. You see, I wasn't gonna stick around for Act Two. Not this guy. I got a reading on Monday morning. So I pick up a lamp, see, and I belted him one. He dropped the gun, and I got it right here. His prints are still on it.
Well, then we've got him.
We? No, I kind of like the sound of that. But look, you know, something's been bugging me about this whole thing.
What?
When Palmer called me a couple of months ago, he said that the Stephen Jessup game was over, that you wouldn't pay him anymore.
He was right.
Yeah, well, he said he had another plan this time. Really big dough, enough to keep me in 8x10s for the rest of my life.
$10,000 to fake a robbery.
You got it. He sent me all the instructions to my address in Queens, the blueprints to this apartment, how many people would be here, the timings, the works. You know, he even wrote my dialogue. So, how could the same plan that you had with Cotton be the exact same plan that Palmer sent to me in Queens?
Coincidence?
Mrs. Forrester, do you think it's coincidence that they planned to fake a robbery on the same night, in the same place, with the same cast?
I guess not.
Well, look, maybe we should just wait for Palmer to get back and ask him, all right? I mean, he should be on his way back now, huh? Look, what do you want to do?
Something very special.
Kill him. Let's kill him.
Oh, no. I'm no good at it. We can call the police. We can prove he killed Ted.
And he can prove that you and Ted were trying to kill him. And I'm an accessory. No. That's attempted murder, lady. No cops. Look, we gotta kill him before he kills us.
Us?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Tell me what to do. What do you mean before he tries to kill us?
He saw me. I saw him kill Cotton. He ain't gonna let me walk around here healthy. He's gotta get rid of me.
But why would Palmer want to kill me?
Why were you gonna kill him?
Ted!
Palmer would never kill for money. Well, yeah, he would kill for money, but he wouldn't kill for love.
He would for good notices.
Look, what was the payoff plan between you and Ted?
A brief period of mourning.
Well, the two plans were identical.
So?
So they had to have the same payoff.
I think I've got it.
You were the target.
Let's kill him.
Great. Look, I'll need Ted's gun. I can't use mine. It's loaded with planks, and I can't use Palmer's.
It's upstairs in my bedroom. Take it to the desk. No, wait.
It's your move, Mrs. Forrester.
Thank you.
taste in music.
And husbands. How are things at headquarters?
Busy. How are things at home?
As they should be. Did you identify the suspect?
He wasn't the man.
You're sure?
Positive. He was much too tall. Blonde hair, blue eyes. He somehow reminded me of your cousin Ralph. I've always hated your cousin Ralph. I want you to know that.
He's crazy about you.
So, all is quiet? No calls, no visitors?
No runs, no hits, no errors.
My witty darling, where is he? Is he hiding? Is he lurking in the shadows?
Who?
You don't know what you're doing, my sweet. You're playing parlor games with a very dangerous man.
I never knew how dangerous you were until tonight.
Not me, Prosciutto.
Who?
The man is a killer.
What man? I don't see any man.
He works for a loan shark. He's here to kill you.
You don't say.
I was paying off my own personal jaws. You stopped paying me, I stopped paying him. He didn't like that. He took it very personally.
And now he wants to kill me. Why?
Because with you dead, I become a very rich man. He gets his money and more.
The envelope, please, and the winner is. It's over, Palmer. He was here. He told me everything. There is no Larry Prosciutto.
Is that what he told you, darling? Did he tell you the one about the unemployed actor on the beach? You didn't buy that, did you? Did he show you his equity card?
Stop laughing!
Did he tell you he was Stephen Jessup?
Shut up, Palmer!
You idiot! There is no Stephen Jessup. I made it up. I took it from a play I was in. You saw it. Murder Among Friends. We closed in Philly.
You're lying!
For God's sakes, you've got to believe me. The man is a killer.
Then why did he kill me?
How the hell should I know? Oh, my God, he wants to kill me. Isn't that it?
No!
That's why he got me out of the house, so he could talk you into helping him kill me.
No!
Of course it is. Don't you see? You'll be paying him for the rest of your life.
Oh, my God, Palmer, what have I done?
Where is he? You've got to tell me where he is.
No, I can't.
Where is he? Don't you see? We've got to kill him before he kills you. You've got to help me.
Yes, Palmer, I'll do anything. Tell me what to do.
All right. Don't walk down and draw blood of all apart. Hello, Palmer. How was the movie?
The man in the black socks was terrific.
Mrs. Forrester, over here with your husband.
But I believed you.
I said over here. Get the gun, Angie! Angie, get the gun!
Give me the gun!
Kill him, Angie! Kill him! Thank you, my darling. Thank you for believing me. I think that was the best performance of my career. Incidentally, you just killed a very bad actor with a very bad accent. Now, what the hell is going on?
Ted and I were going to kill you.
Wrong. Ted and I were going to kill you.
Ted gave me your plan to kill me so we could kill you.
That bastard.
He loved me.
Pull yourself together, Angela. Ted loved only Ted. If he ran out of cigarettes, he would have smoked his own mother. Now, what was all this about the bloody red dress?
It was a signal not to chloroform me.
Huh. I understand Gert's red dress now. When Ted defected to you, he must have called Jessup in Queens and told him, don't chloroform the lady in red. Good for Ted. I didn't think he had it in him.
Your plan didn't work, Palmer.
I must admit, the evening went badly. I wasn't going to pay the junkie. It was going to be heroic. I would come back and I would kill the intruder that killed both my agent and my wife. You can imagine how surprised I was when I opened the safe and found your $25,000. Finders keepers. It's now with the rest of the contents of the safe that the police are looking for.
Then why did you kill Ted?
He was disposable, just like Jessup. You were the main attraction, my darling. I was going to chloroform you.
And now?
Tragic turn of events. You struggle over the gun? It won't be easy, darling. I loved you once, but not now.
Lieutenant, thank God you're still there. My wife has been murdered. Yes, yes, the junkie came back. They must have struggled over the gun. Yes, yes, they're both dead. No, I won't leave. No, I won't touch anything. Please, hurry. Worthy of a Tony.
Forrester, the actor. Lieutenant, thank God you're still there. My wife has been murdered. Yes, that junkie came back. He's dead too. They must have struggled over the gun. Yes, yes, he called me.
Another inspiring performance, Palmer, and it's all on tape.
I couldn't have missed.
You've got Jessup's gun, it's a problem. I have Ted's, it isn't.
Hi, good buddy. Oh, shit. But what about the blood?
Max Factor, yours.
We've got your gun, Palmer. The one you killed Cotton with? The one you tried to kill me with?
What a relief. I've been looking for it everywhere.
It has just your fingerprints on it, Palmer. Just yours.
Thank you for telling me, my darling. May I have it now?
Fat chance. I still think we should kill him. I heard what you said about my accent.
No, I want him in a cell. But I want him to live a long time. You don't have to worry about going to the William Morris Agency, Palmer. You're going to prison.
It's all the same thing. I don't fancy incarceration. And by the way, don't think of using that tape. Yours and Ted's little plot is on it. Attempted murder, darling.
I intend to erase that part.
Should be here any minute.
I shan't be convicted, you know. I'll give the performance of my life, and I'll be acquitted. And then I'll write it myself. How are you going to explain him to them?
There's nothing to explain. He's a good friend. You are, aren't you? A very good, good friend.
Happy New Year, Angie. It's going to be a hell of a year.
Happy New Year, Stephen.
I think I'm going to be sick.
Happy New Year, Palmer. Happy New Year.
Maybe it's too early in the game.